will be contested in three rounds of mixed martial arts action for the vacant featherweight championship. Please bring me first in the blue corner, Mr. Alan Smith.
Alan Smith coming to us. His hometown is Harrisonburg, Virginia. He actually took his first two fights of his MMA career up there before moving to Miami. He always wanted to come to Miami. He used to visit 10th Planet Jiu-Jitsu while he was down here. Got the chance to move to Miami, and he took it and moved in with those 10th Planet guys, making that his home team. In his past fights, he's taken nearly a year off between each three of his fights. His first one coming July 2021, next one July 22, and the last one, most recent one, July of this year. But he told me he's focused on becoming a 52-week athlete. He doesn't want to be going through those camps, then layoffs. So he's focused on becoming a full-time athlete, doing this as a career. And as you see, he put those words to action, fighting barely a month later after his last TKO win over Nathan Honar. He came out strong in that fight, TKO in the first round over at 305 Fights. And his most recent fight before that, won by rear naked choke in the second round for Outlaw Promotions in Harrisonburg. He's got Mike Miguel and Gabe Tata in his corner.
His opponent in the red corner, please send me Mr. Joe Diamond.
Joe Diamond, this is a fighter I can't say enough about. If you want heart, you've got it in Joe Diamond. This is a kid who will never quit. If you've watched any of his last fights, he's coming to us 3-2. But if you see his style, if you don't take him out in that first round, you cannot take him out. He comes with you, comes at you with everything he's got, just relentless force. He's got stamina for days. I trained at Combat Club the other day, actually. I actually got the chance to kind of grapple with him a little in a Shark Tank. And let me tell you, he has a gas tank that does not empty. He was in a Shark Tank, everyone working him. The guys you see in his corner, Stanley Dorsonville, Zachary Wright, just working him. Travis just throwing everything he has at them and training partners. And after the Shark Tank, he was still doing rounds, still doing abs, still shadow boxing, running. I mean, when I left the gym, he was still working. This kid does not quit. And it's a lot of those Combat Club guys that pushed that with him. I mean, Stanley was working with him. Travis obviously encouraging all of them to put in that work. So when you see him and when he fights and he can just give 100% for all three rounds, you know why. And he's got a solid corner. Travis Taylor, like I said, Junior Buscape, tough veteran, former Black Zillion, Impa Kasangane, former UFC fighter, now PFL light heavyweight. He's in the finals. Has a chance at winning $1 million. He's a savage. He used to fight at 170. They needed a last minute replacement for the 205 bracket. Impa hopped in.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your co-main event of the evening, brought to you by Brawler's Box, Sport of King's Room. We're about to contest three rounds of 3 minutes of mixed martial arts action for the Action Fight League Featherweight Championship. Introducing first, standing to my right and fighting out of the blue corner, this man is a jiu-jitsu fighter with a record of 2 wins, 1 defeat. He stands 5'8" tall. He weighed in yesterday at 144.8 lean, mean, and ready pounds, representing 10th Planet Miami and fighting out of Harrisonburg, by God, Virginia. I present to you, Alan Smith! His opponent standing to my left and fighting out of the red corner, this man's a kickboxer. He boasts a kickboxing record of 3 wins and 2 defeats. He stands 6'3" tall. He weighed in at 144.4 lean and ready pounds. Representing the combat club and fighting out of Fairfield, Connecticut, I present to you the real Joe Diamond. Your referee will be Padrino.
Joe also represents Toms River, New Jersey. This is an interesting stylistic matchup. Like I said before, Alan Smith's last win came in the first round very quick. Joe Diamond's 3 wins were all dogfights, but his only 2 losses came very quick, a quick knockout and a quick submission. So if you're Alan Smith, you definitely want to get going quick and catch Joe. And if you're Joe, you want to weather that storm so you can implement your fighting style.
Got a jiu-jitsu fighter versus a kickboxer here.
Classical striker versus grappler.
Yes,
matchup.
It is. Joe Diamond, the taller drink of water. My voice has held up thus far. I will not make it through the main event, Jared.
That bet's looking to turn out good. I wonder if I can go cash it in.
The odds are sailing now to minus 500 at least. Nice, nice over-under lock here for Alan Smith. No nickname. He said, maybe I will earn one tonight.
And Joe is definitely giving a fair bit of resistance.
Indeed, indeed, but not exuding a lot of energy. Staying very calm with it and collected. He is having a fight, though.
And I'd be interested to see what a third round looks like between these guys, because we've never seen Alan Smith in the third round. We've seen Diamond in plenty of third rounds where he's just dogged it out.
Yeah, he's a dog, all right. Oh, nice jab. Joe landed some good shots here.
And that's something we see from Joe. He always works off his jab. He's usually the taller fighter, so.
Nice combination there. Volume and
he's
accurate.
Really connecting.
Big right hands from Alan Smith. Alan Smith might have some scrambled eggs here.
It looks like he's working for that takedown.
Yeah. Turn into his underhook. Might want to get better head position. I'd probably jam that forehead into Joe Diamond's chin if I could. Joe's going to break and strike here off this cage. Nice frame there. Breaks he does. Teep up the middle. Joe Diamond looking to chip away at the chiseled midsection. Good.
And that
good
jab
two-piece.
Has been money.
Yeah, as it is. Another good jab, as you stated. Now going downstairs is Joe Diamond. Alan Smith kind of picking one at a time up top.
We've got a minute to work. I imagine Joe's going to want to keep landing that jab, set it up to open some more shots in the second round. And Alan's going to want to start connecting like he did there with that left hook.
Oh, nice. 112 there from Joe Diamond. That counted. Alan Smith there threw a body kick. He's kind of waiting, looking to see what Joe's going to throw back at him. Man, that jab is just brutal. Good right hand there. Yeah.
Wow.
Good left hook as well. We're going to see what kind of chin Alan Smith's got, because these shots are landing, and they are not as soft as they may look.
And Diamond's just connecting at will now. Almost everything he's throwing is landing on the chin.
Another left hook, but Smith throws one back to keep Joe honest. I was commentating a show in Detroit back at the beginning of June. Joe Diamond was there stepping away, looking to corner some guys.
Up there with Stanley Dorsonville.
Yes, yep, Stanley Dorsonville, a couple others. Big for nothing, John Lopez, also in attendance tonight. Brutal finish there. Yeah, Smith's starting to get wild here. Round one in the books, and Joe Diamond put on a clinic of volume striking like he had a magnet in his hand. Could not miss for half those strikes.
And I've watched all 5 of Diamond's MMA fights. Well, I can say that was the best first round that Joe Diamond has ever had.
You can't have much better of a first round than that, honestly.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, shut the takedown down. Did not get to, and look at that, man. Just hit, bap, bip, bap, bip. And again, they're not thunderous, booming strikes, but they're all touching, and you can clearly see them affecting Alan Smith. Boom. Not really putting him down, but just Smith doesn't have an answer for it.
It's beautiful when that jab lands in.
Yeah.
Travis Taylor did tell me that we should expect to see a much better first round from Joe Diamond. He said in his last fight, Manny Pinto, where he lost, he fought the nicest kid he ever fought, and that kind of kill him with kindness caught Joe off guard.
Can't do that.
Expect a mean Joe this time around.
Yeah.
That jab is mean.
Yeah, the jab is very, very mean. Right hand ain't too nice either. Round number 2 underway. And second verse, same as the first. Starts with a big jab. And Alan Smith trying to punch his way in. Joe Diamond looking to, oh, jabbing Joe.
So it looks like Allen's really trying to take this to the ground. You think if maybe he times that jab.
It's going to be hard to time an onslaught like that. Just duck and shoot.
He might have to eat a few on the
He's eating them anyway.
Might as well make it worth something.
Yeah, absolutely. That jab is a great weapon. Yeah, you can see Smith loading up the right hand now. Joe's going to start picking that apart. Smith may want to change his approach. Start cutting some angles and throwing some feints rather than try to punch his way into a body lock.
And it looks like Smith has some blood leaking out the nose.
I'm sure. He's dropping that right hand to try to slap the body jab and slap the jab away. Joe Diamond's going to start coming over the top with a left hook on that if that keeps happening, I think.
And Diamond's not really loading up. Everything is
no.
just touch, touch,
loading
touch.
Up nothing.
And that's why he's beating Smith
there.
Every
he loaded
time.
The right hand up. That's the first time I was going to load a big shot up, but a nice, nice 1-2-1 reset. Good right hand there. He's catching Allen. He's coming. Allen's cannot get offense going here. Kind of overwhelmed.
Looks like he's trying to come over with that right hand, but he's not setting it up with much.
He's not setting it up. He's not having a lot of luck landing it.
And that body kick looked like it folded Allen a little bit.
Stop and put the mouthpiece back in. How did Joe lose his mouthpiece?
That's what I'm wondering.
Did they start to brown with it? Leg kick from Allen Smith. Yeah, Allen Smith That's can certainly it. Polish up a strike in a little bit. He's tough. He's got, I mean, his defense is, he's just a step behind Joe.
Yeah.
That's good inside there. I jacked that underhook up a lot quicker.
But it's the same thing every time. Joe's beating
yeah.
him, shoveling in, fending him off from the takedown.
Yeah, and you come forward with a game plan hoping the guy gasses out, but you're the one that's taking the shots, and that makes you more tired. Joe Diamond is doing this for 20 rounds at this pace.
He looks fresh as ever.
Yeah. Oh.
If anything, he looks better than he did in the first round.
Looks better than he did in any of his other first rounds for sure. Man, just supreme confidence in that jab. Just throwing it up there anytime.
It's like you said, it's a magnet.
Anytime he wants to think, he throws a jab. Anytime he wants to change angles, he throws a jab. Anytime he wants to move forward, throws a jab. And, oh, good. A little shoe shine to the body there. Loosening up. Now, may smell a finish coming, Joe Diamond. Not this round, though.
It looked like Allen kind of backed up when he took those two to the body. You think that hurt him a bit?
I know that it didn't massage him. I can tell you that for certain.
So at this point, Diamond is one round away from taking home that belt, but Smith.
I don't know. I mean, it may not go. It may not go the last round, if we're being honest here.
We know Smith has got power, though, so if he can land that shot, it can work. But the way
yeah.
it's going now, Diamond's a step ahead everywhere.
Tootsie Roll. Man, just an output clinic there from the real Joe Diamond. That's just Joe the real Diamond, I believe.
Yeah.
But that's just awkward for me to say. Sorry, kid.
Travis actually told me because there was Dustin Diamond Poirier, they put the real Diamond because he is the real Diamond.
That's his real name. I don't think it'd be worth it trying to claim that nickname just yet. Maybe one day.
If he keeps performing like this, he'll be on that track.
It could be one day. Absolutely, that could be one day. For third and final round. If we need three of the final minutes. Allen Smith looking to crash. That was right over the top. Allen Smith needs to figure out how to implement his game plan because so far Joe Diamond has been coasting.
And that entry looked a little bit better because
it
he fainted
better.
The overhand. But
yep. Fainted, yep. He's trying to punch his way in. He's throwing that overhand, which Joe Diamond pretty much sees.
Oh, wow, that jab, just like rounds one and two, yeah, still landing.
Just like all the rounds. All the rounds, all the jabs. No problem.
And, yeah, Joe knows everything he's throwing. It's always,
man,
just trying to end
it.
Oh, right,
man, two low, one high.
Mixing it up well.
Somewhere Nick Diaz is smiling at that. Oh, man, just that jab is just unstoppable. It's like Chinese water torture, man. It's death by a thousand cuts.
Oh, my God.
There, that's the best. That's the time. He took his feet away, but Joe off the cage. Ring awareness. You got to get off that warning track. And he did just that and back on the attack immediately.
And Smith landed that same leg kick earlier. So
yeah,
it seems like one of the things that's been working for him.
Yeah, and to his credit, I mean, Smith is not tired. He just can't get through this. You know, if you study old warfare, you can't get your batting ram there through the archers. They just keep getting poked away with the arrows.
That's exactly what happened. Joe's sniping him.
Yeah, exactly what it is. Man, he kind of casted that right hand and then threw the jab reset. Just ending with a jab, starting with a jab, middling with a jab, solo in the jab.
And now we got...
Again, another one, countering with a jab, circling with a jab. There's a right hand because he felt like it. Joe's had good right hands. Joe's had some, but it's just that jab has just been something, man. Oh, right there. Took a leg kick, though.
Yeah. Smith kind of loaded up on it.
Yeah, I feel like Smith has to get him on the ground right now.
And it looks like
right now,
Diamond smells blood in the water.
Yeah, oh, body shot and then one upstairs.
Shoveled right in there.
Another takedown attempt there. Not a bad one, but Joe had both underhooks down low. You want to fake the takedown and then bring the right hand upstairs because Joe is committing both hands to those underhooks. Now he sees the takedown coming.
He's done the reverse. He's fainted the overhand.
Yeah. Now you want to do Kevin Randleman, Crow Cop 1.
And that's all that can win the fight for Smith right now.
Not now. Time is up.
Oh.
Time has expired. Both guys, look fresh. Allen doesn't look as pretty as he did when he got here. But both guys look pretty fresh. Conditioning was not a factor. The factor, there you see, just the volume punching. And, man, I've been talking all night about guys controlling range. I talk every fight about guys controlling range. Joe Diamond just found his range and just put his foot in the tire and stayed there this whole fight. I mean,
he didn't look to slow down for a second.
No. Allen Smith had some moments, had some big strikes, some big shots, forced some clinches, but Joe Diamond just said, okay, patient, 1, 2, 3, I'm out, and more of this. More of this.
There's a jab.
More of that. More of that. More of that. Here's one of these. Put some in my hand for me, Powder. One more of that. And see, that jab took away. They actually slowed the takedown.
Yeah.
The takedown was coming. Joe interrupted the rhythm with that jab and just saw the takedown coming. Just, man, the jab is so important. Wow.
Every time Smith came in, landed that jab. And like Travis Taylor said, it definitely looks like we saw, I can't even say a meaner Joe. He didn't look like super mean or anything. But he definitely was not going to give Allen Smith a moment to catch him like Joe got caught in his last fight. Made the changes he needed to, and he'll be taking home a belt with him, provided the judge's decision goes as we expect it to. Joe actually told me before this fight, he doesn't care if he kills his opponent. He doesn't care if his opponent kills him. He wants to do anything necessary to get the win. No killing was necessary tonight, but Joe will get the win.
Ladies and gentlemen, sport of King's Room. That concludes our co-main event. After three hard-fought rounds, all three judges scored the fight exactly the same, 30-27 for your winner by unanimous decision. And now the Action Fight League featherweight champion, Joe the Real Diamond. Ladies and gentlemen, I am here with your winner and new champion of the Action Fight League, Joe, the Real Diamond. Joe, you put on a clinic in range management, volume punching, and exceptional accuracy. One, I started asking on commentary whether you had magnets in your gloves. You just couldn't miss. I spoke to you back in Detroit. You were up there cornering some of your teammates in Detroit for another show, and you said you'd take some time away to really focus, and you were going to fight when you were told you were ready. And I hope you were told you were ready, because tonight you looked almost flawless. Take a moment and talk us through the preparation, what you focused on your time away.
I focused on discipline and working at the gym every single day. I mean, that's what I do every single day, because I don't have a job. I live alone. My parents live in Brooklyn and Connecticut. So I'm always here working with my team, and that's pretty much it.
Well, your hard work and your dedication were on display. A performance like tonight does not happen by accident. So that bumps you up. That's your sixth MMA fight, I believe, as an amateur. Now you got a belt over your shoulder. We'd love to have you defend it here, but I have to ask, what's next for you? Are you going to keep grinding out the amateur scene? Are you looking to maybe make the jump to the pro ranks? What's next for Joe Diamond?
I want to do one more amateur fight for a belt. Any organization, I don't really care. But there's one that I'm looking at. It's Rise of a Warrior. So I already have the 150 kickboxing championship. Why not get the MMA 45?
So you're saying that right now it's MMA all the way?
MMA all the way.
Man, you put on a clinic tonight. I look forward to watching you fight wherever it may be. I hope I get to commentate it. Absolutely. Take a moment.
I want to thank my parents for believing me every single day. And this was probably one of the hardest MMA camps that I've had. My great-grandmother died recently during the week. And it hurt me so bad just thinking about it while I was training. So I want to thank God. And I want to thank her. This win was for her mostly. And I want to thank God for the championship and all these lovely people out here clapping for me. Thank you all. I love you all.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for your champion, the featherweight king round these parts, Joe the Real Diamond.